Okay. This is the last topic of processes. Process is, our approach in teaching process is very strange, right? In the beginning, we have system calls, telling you what are the system calls, and then we go deep into the kernel, and suddenly we go back to the user level to talk about cooperations. Now, this chapter, this part is a mix of all the topics. You will find scheduler, you will find mutual exclusion, you will find IPC, you will find some part even not being taught, which is a memory. Okay? So you have to stay very close with me, or you don't understand some important things. So what are threads? What are threads? Threads, some people call it a lightweight process. Okay? A process which is a smaller one. Okay? And why it behaves like a process? Because this is a one way to allow a job, okay, that totally under your control and let it to run parallelly. Okay? It is a way to write parallel program. And here you find a place here. It's the projector is upgrade. Yeah. Last time I teaching last year, the color is not that sharp.
Okay.
Oh. So we have a bunch of memory here, but now you find that there's a piece of memory which is extra. Let's go through this. We have a global variable, malloc, and code. And what is the piece of memory that's extra? The two local variables. We have two set now. What is the meaning of two sets of local variables? It basically means that these two guys, okay, hiding within a process, there is a two execution body. These two body have two separated pieces of local variable. Okay? So, this is fantastic, right? As if I have two processes running together, but these three guys, the global variable, the malloc, and as well as the code they share. Wow. So what is the meaning? What is the meaning they share the code? Meaning that they run the same program. Okay? As if you are doing fork after fork, you share the same program, because you duplicate the program. Now it's not duplicated program, it's really sharing the program. They execute the same code and they share malloc and global variable. And this is why we need to talk about IPC when you write this kind of program. Okay? And what is this part? This part, the scheduler. Okay, the scheduler, we need to understand how a scheduler or how operating system look at threads. Okay? Yeah, very simple. When a scheduler or the OS don't know what is a thread, then you are not really going to have a parallel processing, right? You don't know what is a thread. So you emulate it as if, it run in parallel. But if the scheduler know what is thread, then they will schedule based on thread. Okay? So now it's become very important, right? So all topics come together. Okay? And we become this last part, which is very useful. I will say that if you're IE students, okay, you will write threads very soon. Okay? At least you will have a software engineering class that may write thread. If they don't write thread, then later on you write a lab program to use thread. And for CS student, if you take my 4430 course, you will write threads. Okay? But in OS, we don't. okay. So let's go. The introduction. So this is thread, right? Thread is a line, something like that. So usually where can you find threads? You find threads whenever you find an application, you have things running together. They run in parallel, then you will find threads. So very interesting example that these two. A software with a GUI, graphical user interface. So what is the meaning of having a graphical user interface? Now let's imagine. Imagine what? You are writing a game called Bomberman, okay? Yeah, Bomberman. Yeah, you know, how many of you don't know what is Bomberman, okay? This is the best example I can find, okay? So when you play Bomberman, there is a clock, right? Doing countdown. 2 minutes. Within 2 minutes, you have to kill all of the opponents, or it is a draw game, right? So you will have one parallel job as a clock countdown. Another, at least you have multiple players, right? Multiple players, I don't know whether the players are all sharing the same keyboard or not, okay? Yeah, can we share a keyboard with 5 players?
Okay.
Yeah, forget about this. Okay, let's maybe two, okay, two people sharing a keyboard. So the two players as well as the computer player, they should be separated, right? The computer player move by itself. You as a human player use the keyboard to move the thing, okay? They are parallelized, right? So the clock, the human player, the computer player all run in parallels. One more is something that you IR. This investment you don't have graphics. Okay? So basically what is updating the screen? Updating the screen means that you redraw the entire screen once. Okay? And then clean it up and redraw it again. Okay, so basically one more thread. That means all things that execute in parallel are threads. Particularly network pointers, you need it. Because let's say we have let's say BT. Okay, BT connect to hundreds of people. You want to download things in parallel, right? With the hundreds of people. So how to do it in parallel? Using threads. Okay? So my example is quite stupid, okay? My example here is one thread for networking, one thread for GUI control. Let's say, I don't know why you love Flash, okay? Yeah, Flash sucks, okay? Usually when you run it, your CPU will get burning, okay? Let's say we have threads for Flash Player, okay? So at least we have 3 threads. Let me open it up. No. So let's say here, assuming, bit. I don't know why when I upgrade to upgrade to Mac OS, it becomes something red here. Okay. So can you see this? My Dropbox spawning thread like crazy. Where are you, Dropbox? Hey, don't go away. Hey, don't hide. Hiding, you cannot hide. I find you, okay. 42 threads executing in parallel. Okay? So you already know why. Because it's want to download things in parallel together, monitoring your SIP file system whether the folder Dropbox is updated or not. Periodically. Okay? So you have threads. Very seldom that we don't have threads. As long as we have GUI, then you have threads, so a BASH, okay? It is not a. Right, you don't have a GUI Waffle interface, so no threads. How about others? Wow, who are you? Cloud D. Very suspicious, huh? Chrome is very threads, very horrible. Huh? Anything go beyond 100? No. Right, sort by thread. I'm stupid. Okay. The winner is Dropbox. How about your machine? Who is the winner? When you just open a computer, you need Dropbox, right? Okay. Oh, by the way, how long are my computer is run? What happened? Wow. What happened? Oh, I zoom out. What's so mean? Okay. let's say how long my computer has run. There is a command called uptime. Oh, my computer run for 40 days. Okay, so 40 days I accumulate so many things. So, yeah, whatever. Okay? So, well, basically you already know that why we need thread. Because we want multitasking. Okay? And as a matter of fact, what is the true meaning of multitasking is basically you want to let me use a computer programmer description. you want to distribute the blocks to different threads. So what is the meaning of distributing blocks? Now, let's imagine that, okay, I want to write a program. The program, at the same time, will read from the keyboard, read from the network, and try to play music, let's say. Okay, while you're playing music, okay, you just read from file and play, read from file and play, okay? So, but can you read from the keyboard during your reading from keyboard and play music together? Now think about it, how do you write, why can you write that program? When you write that program, you read from skip keyboard, maybe you call F get X, right? When you call it F get X, can you play music? Yes, how? Use another process, right? I mean the same process, okay? Don't say that, oh, launch another process, do it. No, it's the same process. Can you do it? You know you cannot. You call F get X, then the entire process is there, okay? Stand there waiting for an input. You don't type any input, you cannot do anything, right? This is a normal process behavior. So we need threading. The true meaning is multitasking in distributing the time that we will block. Let's say I want to play music together with calling fgetx. So I assign one thread to call fgetx, another thread to read from the music file and play it. But don't forget that reading from a music file also have blocking times, right? When reading it, you may have a 1 or 2 millisecond block. Okay, but still it is a possibility for you to block, okay? Or you want to do some calculation together with the time that you call FKS from your keyboard. Okay, so this is the true meaning why we need threading. I mean, in most of the use case. Some use cases that you just want to do parallel computation, okay? So, I mean a parallel computation in the sense that you want to draw the power from all cores. Okay, you have eight cores. You have 8 cores, then you send out 8 threads, okay, to try to take advantage of the number of cores you have. Okay? But here I just give an example, you try to distribute the chance that you block. Okay? So I write a program to demonstrate this. Okay? So what is this program? This program, let me first play with you together. Okay, so what is it? Okay, so what is this? Because it's a game, so I write an introduction here. I write it. This is just a very stupid game, big or small, okay? So tell me it is big or small, okay? If you know that, okay, press enter, okay? And there is a one thread to do the countdown. One thread waiting for your input, okay? Very interesting. Two threads run together. Okay, well, when I enter, it will stop, okay? Stop. And big or small, Okay, this is what? This is big. Yeah. This is big, okay? Small. Small, what's up? Okay. Yeah. So can you see I get some points? 6 points. Now, when 10 points, it will level up. Small. Yeah, but I only have one life left. Right? Level two is faster.
Where is the
clock? Yeah. Don't disturb me. Small. Okay.
Small.
Wait. Big and small. Small. Ayah! It's decision to end. End means they are all the same. Okay? So this game will do what is the implementation, right? Why it can do something like this? Now look at here, I don't have anything. And wow. Cut out. And then you continue to wait for your input. So how to do it? One thread is doing a countdown, one thread is doing a relay. Okay, so let's see it. Maybe VIM is colorful. Yeah, colorful. So basically, I have implemented all things, okay? So I just highlight some of the things that you may be able to understand. So you can see a big game here. So whenever you find a symbol like this, okay, it means this is a thread. Later on, I will tell you why. I mean, this is a thread. So one thread is controlling the game flow. Okay, this is a game flow. There's a while one, you know, there's a while one, that means that it's keep looping. Okay, while it's keeping the loop, while it's looping, go down, what is intro. Okay, and I have another thread. I have two threads. One is the gameplay, another is called re-input. So let me search for it. Yeah, when you see this, usually there's a thread. So this, can you see what I'm doing? This thread, you don't need to look at these lines, okay? Look at the things that you already understand. While one get char. Yeah, this thread is always doing while one get char. Yeah, can you see this? I can specialize one thread to read from a keyboard, specialize another thread for the main game flow. And they won't disturb each other. Okay? While it's doing countdown, that reading thread will always waiting to read your input. So this is what I mean to distribute the tasks. Okay? So that means that you are now capable to write this kind of program. At least you have two keyboards, okay? Then you can try two player games, okay? So, in terms of programming, what is going on here? You see my example, I say that I will create two threads, okay? So what is the meaning of create two threads? Now, this is a memory architecture. You already know that a memory architecture, I have codes, I have a global variable, malloc, as well as a local variable. Now, what are the bubbles here? One bubbles is a blue bubbles. The blue bubbles is one of the thread. You don't need to take care of whether this is a main, okay? The main or not the main, because we still have the main, right, running. So I just hide that there is no main, okay? Let's say there is no main. So I have two threads running. One guy is called blue guy. One is called red guy. Now the code, you know the code is read only, okay? But whenever it's a thread, we have something called thread function. A function that I specialize for a thread. You can see this previously. I say that there's a void star there, then that is a thread. Okay, so you can see it is two from my previous game. So I have two specialized functions that the thread will execute. So here comes a new concept that process, you know, when you do a fork, when after a fork a process, then it will start executing, and I don't know what is the location, but right after the fork. Now here is inside a function. So you can assign a function for that thread, another function for another thread, or a bunch of functions sharing the same thread, no problem. Now, a bunch of threads sharing a function. Yeah, no one here that I said the reverse thing. Good.
Okay. Good.
That means that you guys are digesting what I'm saying.
Good.
Okay? So these two guys, the malloc as well as global variable. Now these two guys are evil. Evil guy. Because these two bubbles will share them. What does the meaning of share them? Both will access the same piece of memory. And can access the same piece of memory. And look at my previous game. I enter whether it's book big or small, okay? Basically, that big or small, I write it to a global variable so that the two threads can communicate. The main game flow know that I got a wrong answer or a correct answer. The reading thread will pass that answer to the computation task, okay? So day of share. So it will be race condition. Will be race condition as well as all kinds of problems that we talk about. Next, the local variable. The local variable are good guys. Okay, they are separated. Two guys are separated, meaning that they have their own private zone for that thread. Now, how to write the simplest threading program? Okay, so the basic programming. The library that we will use will call pthread, or the POSIX thread. POSIX is the operating system standard. Okay, this kind of thread, okay, will have some one-to-one correspondence with something that you already heard of. Let's say the fog, okay? You have fog, and one-to-one correspondent is, this is for creating thread, creating process, this create thread, called pthread create. Okay, don't spell it wrong, don't miss this E, okay, many people miss this E. PID, it's a PID, now it's another structure to represent PID. Get PID, you can change in get self, what else, exit, also we have wait, and also we have queue. Okay, so most of the operations that you work over process will find a counterpart in a thread. So don't worry that you don't know how to use it. Basically, you already know how to use it, just you don't know how to call it. Okay, so how to call it? This is the simplest program. Okay, how simple it is? As if I'm doing function call. Okay, I create a thread. Okay, I put in a TID or the thread structure. Because it's just a pass by reference, so I give it a pointer so that the functions get updated for me. And what is this hello and hello world? Okay, thread, very interesting. It being kept inside a function. So you have to declare a function like this. This is a signature that you have to follow. Usually it's void star. Void asterisk, not star, okay, void asterisk. And then the function name, then you pass the function name here, and what is it? This is the only input to the thread. You can pass only one input, okay? No more, only one. Now, say we have to pass in many things, don't worry, just set up a structure. Okay, pass in a structure. Okay, only one variable that you can pass in. So that you can tell this thread to do different things than another thread. Okay? Now, what will happen? What will happen is, this will start at scale and quit. Just like exit zero here. And here, what happened here is, I call pthread joins. What is pthread join? Go to here. Can you look up what is pthread join? What is it for a process? Wait. It is wait. Okay? So I tell the mother thread, you go to wait for a moment. Okay? Waiting whom? Wait this guy. Positive team guy in here. Okay? So this is the basics, but my functions that I share with you is not the basic one. Okay, so I want to demonstrate it is running in parallel so that I make it into a very, very big trunk of things. Hello world.c. Hey, what happened? Wait. Okay, come back. So you know, ELG wave is always like that. Good. Okay. So I want to show that it can run for a long time and run in parallel. Okay, so I tell the child thread to loop for many times. Okay, and while it's looping, it will print out something like just like a singing. Okay, and then here, the mother thread before it's called the joins or the process version is awake, before it waits, it will also print something. But this time it's just come up with some crazy sound. Okay? So what will happen? What will happen? So this guy after the mother thread, after it create a new thread, it will start looping. As well as the child thread also do a looping, you can see that they will jam in the output in parallel way, in a parallel manner. And then the mother thread would wait and say that main thread terminated. Okay, so let's go. So because I'm more than one core, so that you will see this running really in parallel. So you will see that because the loop size is the same. Okay, so you will find the mother thread comes preload first, and then here with a T here is a child thread, mother, child, and hello world. What is the hello world? What is hello world? Hello world is the input that I pass in. I use the input, okay? So look at the input here. I pass in hello world. Okay? Very hard to click up. Here. Hello world, just pass in. So by the end of the thread, I will print out the inputs and then die. And it will die. So you can see this both things execute in parallel. Okay?
What if there's no pthread join and the mother thread dies first?
Well, good. How can I make the mother thread die first? Ah, yes. Yes, I just put a break here. Okay, you want something like this, right? And also this. Yeah, you want something like this. Good. So there's good questions. Okay. My anticipation is both thread dies. Why? Okay, I will tell you why. So let's see. Yeah, really both thread dies. Why I said both thread dies? The main thread dies, but when the main thread dies, the child thread don't have a chance to go in the CPU to run. So if I put the break later, put the break already very late. Stupid. No one tell me. You guys don't tell me. Yeah, see? Both red dies. Both red dies. Now, why is both threads will die? Okay, I can explain to you very easy. Because the return zero signal. Because of the return zero signal. So what is the meaning of return zero? Return zero, I never explain this in great details. Now I disclose another meaning of return zero. Return zero means eventually it coexists zero, right? And what is the meaning of exist zero? Kill the process. Okay? So the child thread is a family member of this process, so the entire family gone. Yeah, kill them all. No. How can I explain? This return zero is the same as you miss out return zero because eventually it called return. Right? This is a function. Main is a function. When you quit main, you will return. Okay? So maybe I demonstrate another thing. Maybe I demonstrate it's not break. It's an exit. Yeah, it's exit. So no break. So both thread will die. Both thread will die. See? Both thread will die. Because Q or exit, no matter Q and exit, okay? You want to kill the process. And all child threads will die at the same time. Okay? Because it's just a member of this process. Okay? Any problem you want to ask? Any further problem you want to ask? Yes?
You go and thread to the homeboy exit though. The homeboy exit your parents.
Can the thread coexist? Of course. Of course we can. Yeah, let's demonstrate, yeah? So let me change it back to the original look. Okay, it's original now. Put back pthread join. Okay, so our classmate say that he want to coexist inside the child thread. Yeah, that's the same. Because you send a command that, hey, please kill the entire process. So both things dies together. Now go. Both things die together. Okay? So make me very clear. Thread is just a member. Okay? It's a belonging of a process. Whenever you call something related to process, you will affect all threads. So there is some definition saying that in some books, okay? Whenever you call fog when you have thread, it depends on the operating system how you manage it, okay? But this is not fog this time, it's very clear, it's a queue in the process. Now, how about inside thread you call fog? I don't know. I don't know, because it's totally, you know, it's totally nonsense, right? You have 10 threads, you call fog, so I duplicate all 10 threads. Right? Or just duplicate the calling thread. Oh, then it's very, very interesting. Then does it equal to a prefect create inside a thread? That's a philosophical problem. Very, very complicated. Okay? So that's why I said, I don't know. Okay? Don't ask me. Write the program and prove it. And I can guarantee to you that, you have to try it out. Every time you come to this big up class, what happened to you? So, Lina Melody, but. Moment. Thank you. Yeah, she don't know how to write prefect. Okay, so I explained all these things already. Okay? So, now I give you something horrible. Now, this is something that I should teach you very, very beginning, so that you won't make it wrong. What is that? Now, I give you 1 minute. This screenshot is the true screenshot, okay? You compare the code, and I'm trying to understand why I have this shocking phrase. Look at the code, I give you 1 minute. Okay, now first of all, I ask you some questions. Input to the thread, right? This is the input to the thread. What is the thing that I pass into the thread? What is the thing that I pass into the thread? No one knows what is that? You are in a big trouble. Yeah, I send you back to ENGG 1010. My junior programming course today. What is that? The address of input variable, right? I send the address of the input variable to the thread. And so happened that the thread treat this as address, right? Because you have a voice star there, voice asterisk is there. So that guy will be treated also as an address. So type match, right? I give you an address, you treat it as an address. No problem, right? No problem. But you know, I already say that this thread and this thread, they execute into two different areas. You have your local variable, I have your local variable, right? We both have different local variables, and they are separated, okay? Now, problem comes. Here, I try to dereference this input, right? Because it is a pointer, it is an address, so I need to dereference it. Before I dereference it, I cannot directly dereference it. Okay? If I directly dereference it, it becomes void type. Okay? So what's void? I don't know. So I have to cast it back to an integer pointer and then dereference. So it becomes an integer. Right? Now, if you understand this line, then you should have no problem in understanding this, right? I also do the same thing, but this time I set 20. And then print it out and terminate the thread. After the thread finished execution, this pthread join is the wait. Okay, originally it was waiting, now it will unblock and execute line 13. Now let's see. I improved this program a bit. This program should be called an evil one, so it's an evil program. I improve it a bit. I pass in a random number, okay? So you won't see it always a 10, okay? But if you want 10, I can make it 10, okay? So then here, I also use a random, okay? Make it into 20. Oh yeah, no. Being 20. So then it is just the same as 10 and 20, right? The same as this program. Yeah, I know I have double, okay? You don't want it, okay? Okay, they are the same now. Now, execute it. Execute is Ctrl-X. Evil one. Yeah. So it seems that the thing inside the thread will modify the thing outside or in another thread. And what is the reason? The reason is very easy to understand. Now, this is the memory based on time. Okay? Now, the time is I execute up to this line only, line 9. Okay? Now when I execute this 9, very hard to pronounce. 9. Don't say it too fast. Right? So you only have one piece of local variable. Now I execute line 11. Execute line 11, then you will create another set of local variables. But this two set of local variables, although I don't know whether you understand or not, okay? Calling a function, the parameter is also a member of the local variable set. This is also a local variable. Do you understand this? Do you know this? No? Oh, shoot. Function call, the parameter, is also a local variable. Okay? So that's why we have the effects of pass by failure. Yeah, you finally understand what is pass by failure. Because you create a local variable and copy it. Oh. Who teach you C?
You.
No, I teach you Java. Don't say lies, okay? This year, I told the year one this story. Everybody said, oh.
And they seem that they don't understand, okay?
This is a local variable. So you have a new box here to store the input pointer. You have a blue box storing the input value. Okay, so they are separate box. And this is the meaning of What I mean, they separate two local range. This is the true meaning. But unfortunately, this red box is not storing integer value. It's store pointer. You store an address. And this address so happened that point to this location. So although I didn't say anything wrong, right? I didn't tell lies. They really separated. The void input really a separated local variable in another song, but the input value is a pointer pointing to the old local variable song. And that's why you can change it. And this is very dangerous. Many junior programmers writing pthreads will get this problem because they try to pass some variable to the thread and let the thread introduce it. Okay? So what should you do? Yeah, just global. Global is good, but global have phrase condition. So usually I would the next step I tell people to do is very easy, right? You know that this will modify the old stack. So why don't you create a new variable inside a new stack and back it up? Back up the value. Don't directly change it, right? You are directly changing it. This is wrong. Back it up. Create a new variable here to back it up. Right? Let's try this. To back it up, let's say the just call it backup, okay? Backup equal to, yeah? Okay? Then here, don't do this. Become backup equal to 20. Right, then you won't change anything in the original thread, right? Because you are changing another thing. Are you satisfied with the solution? Good enough, right?
Then you will print 2 10 in the 12.
Oh, you're right, I didn't change it. Yeah. I don't want to change too much because I don't want to do it. Yeah, this year I still use this code, right?
That's why now I need to undo it. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. You're talking about this line, right? Yeah, I need to change also this into a... Yeah, okay, I change it. Okay. I just want to be lazy. Back up, okay?
Good.
Yeah?
I don't set up Git here, okay?
Fine. Good. So I undo it, because next year I will reuse it. Okay, good. Now, what's next? Can you see in my directory that we have evil 2? Evil 2 is horrible. How horrible it is. It's as if there is a student listen to what I said, doing backup. Okay, so this is a backup code. And what is the variable that's being passed in? Let's imagine that this is an ID, okay? In the main thread, I use a for loop to create threads. Okay, I'm lazy, I just, we using this I, okay, and create two loops, okay? Now, this two loops, the first loop is the creation, and the second loop is the wait. Now, I remember you have, I'm not you, only some of you have asked these questions, okay, in assignment one. You ask me, okay, the wait PID, okay, which process I need to wait first, okay? I said usually, the answer is whatever, okay? You can call 123 or 321 or 213, I don't care, okay? As long as you wait for all processes to die. Now, here is the same concept. You wait for all 5 processes to die, that's okay. So it should be no problem, right? I pass in the ID. I use the ID passing here and back up the ID so that I print my ID number out. Now, let you see some magic. Magic. Okay. Now, first of all, give you the look of that evil number 2 program. Okay? I become even more lazy. Okay? I don't initialize it. This is the same, okay? Lazy man. Even more lazy, okay? They are the same, right? Right. No problem, no problem. Okay, let me execute it. Okay. Now, take a look. Now, take a look at the I. I start with 0. Look at the ID list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again. Oh, no, not again. Okay. Again. Thank you.
Before I come, I try one time, 5-5. Wait, wait, wow, this time you're 7.
Yeah.
Wait, 8. It's just a lucky draw, right? Hey, come on, come on. I have 9. Can you see 9 here? Wait, okay, yeah.
Don't feel amazed, okay? Why? This is not amazing time, this is a horrible time.
Very horrible. Okay, this is the code. Time for a break, right? Why we have all 5?
Give you a break, after the break, also this is the recommendation.
Okay?